All right, here we go. Salute to the Knicks Nation, CP the Franchise here. We are outside in New York City in the West Village at Burgerhead. We're about to chop it up with the owner and proprietor, my guy Will, a diehard Knicks fan. We're going to go inside, get some grub, and chop it up with Will on the state of New York Knicks, man. Let's go inside.
We're a burger spot in the West Village. We opened a couple of months ago, and we specialize in char-grilled burgers. So we kind of do something a little different than what's out there. We don't do traditional smash burger. We cook ours on an open flame, and we just try and give people the best burger, you know, that we can. Classic all-American style burger.
All right, there we go, man. So I just ordered the double char burger. My guy Centro got the single joint, and we got the impossible. We're gonna try it out and let you know, man. We'll let you know our thoughts.
All right, so right now we're about to try out the double char burger. I got three burgers here, but it's for the team. It's for Kenny and Centro. So but I'm gonna try out this double joint right here. Okay, we got some bacon on here, lettuce, tomato, got the secret sauce on here. All right, here we go, man, cheers. Good money.
CB the Franchise, my guy Will in the building. Yo, thanks for having us, man. The food was on point,
man. I really appreciate it.
Absolutely, man. So, as we told the fans, man, you're a diehard Knicks fan. Yeah. Give me your Knicks fan origin story, man.
Man, just being born and raised in New York, I don't actually remember the day I started like it, but just growing up, watching with my dad, my cousins, my family, it's just been a part of me forever. It's the only team I still care deeply about, you know. Growing up, I was into all the New York teams, but as I got older and time's gotten scarcer, I've only stayed with the Knicks. And it's just one of those things that brings back childhood memories and just being with family and my boys watching games. You know, I was there for the 90s runs, and that was a big part of my life, so it just sticks with me.
That's what I was about to say. We're about the same age, so it was the 90s that captivated you, right?
It's what kept us going this whole time, too, at least me, you know.
Yeah.
Through all the bad years, you have those good years that we're hoping is happening now again, so it's exciting, man.
Absolutely, man. You know, this Knicks team right now is making tremendous strides, making tremendous moves. I mean, we've come a long way. Like I said, we're the same age. We've come a long way. What is it like watching this team now be competitive and have a competent front office?
It's insane, man. It makes me so happy. And just like, not that it came from out of nowhere, because you saw the good moves happening over the last couple of years, you know, with the new, you know, since Rose came in, and you saw it happen. Then it just kind of just happened, like, not overnight, but it is just there it is. And like, for so many years, we're always trying to get the big guy, the star, make some big splash trade, and we finally did it. Like, homegrown, we built this team to where it is, you know, and I think just Brunson is just a gift that we're so lucky that we got, you know, and I think he's changed the culture of the team to a point where the next few years are just bright, in my opinion.
What were your impressions of him when we first got him to now?
You know, I think, like anyone, like, there was all this, we're overpaying for. I didn't believe that. I wasn't expecting too much. I was happy that we finally had a point guard. I think that was like the extent of it, like a legit point guard coming to the team. And, you know, I don't think anyone really thought what happened would happen, you know. But so when he came, I was excited, cautiously, you know, optimistic, which I think as a Knicks fan, you kind of have to be. But it's turned out fantastic, and he's just proven himself to be such a, you know, selfless person and player, and what he's doing to help hopefully bring the team the championship that we're all waiting for. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Well said, man. What was your reaction when the Mikal Bridges trade went down?
I was pretty wild, man. Yeah. You know, I was excited. Like, I didn't think that was going to happen. So it was just like one of those, like, they're really going in on the Villanova thing, and I think it's fantastic, you know. I was sad to see Hardenstein go. I was hoping we were going to figure something out there. You know, I hate change, so not having that same core team, you know, I thought that was a big part of what we did last year, but I believe that, you know, we got it what we need, and we've gotten better, so I'm excited to see where this season goes. I mean, I think everyone is, that's the only thing, where everyone's so excited, you know. We could easily be disappointed. But I don't see that. I'm really happy for what's happening.
Yeah, sure. You know, disappointment is a part of the game. But I think they put a coherent plan in place.
Yeah.
And we haven't had that in a while, man.
100%. Yeah. They've stuck with a plan. They've built this team slowly over time, not rushed into things, not made splashy trades. They've made the right moves. And, you know, I think in a league that's all about splashy moves, and we're doing the opposite. And I I hope and believe it's going to pay off. You know, I'm just like, can't wait for this season to start. It's really exciting.
How do you think they stack up in the East? You know, Celtics are the kings of the league right now, kings of the East. You have Philadelphia, who just made moves. They got Paul George. They just picked up Yabusele from France. So they're making a lot of depth moves there. What do you think about where the Knicks stand?
I think it's the Celtics that are more of an issue than Philly. I think Embiid is going to prove to not, I don't know. I don't like that dude at all. So, you know. whatever, man. Like, he's not the MVP he was. Like, I don't think he ever was the MVP. So I'm not too concerned about Philly. You know, I think this.
Well, full disclosure, your family's from Serbia. So is that why you don't think he's the MVP? Keep it real.
There is. I think he definitely robbed Jokic of that for 100%. You know, I'm a diehard Knicks fan. Once the Knicks are out of the picture, I'm gonna root for one of my Serbs. Yeah, so, yeah. But just the way he was, I don't know, he was played dirty last season, so.
Yeah, he did try to injure our guy, Mitch, man. I didn't like that at all, man. That was a dirty play.
That's not, I don't know. You're not going to get far like that. I truly believe that. So, I mean, he did okay in the, Olympics. That's cool.
Yeah.
But I'm not worried about him. Celtics make me more nervous.
Yeah. Is that your sleeper team in the East, Pacers?
I think I'm more concerned about them than, I think, personally, with the rivalry. And I just feel like anyone coming to the Garden always gets, it's like, it's fuel to them. So that's our disadvantage. The Garden gives so many advantages, but the other team also comes correct in the Garden because of the Garden.
Yeah,
so.
There's been many a night where we turn like the average bum into a superstar in Madison Square Garden, man. You've seen it.
In the Garden, so, but I think it's us and the Celtics going for the East this year, so it's exciting, man.
Yeah. But we did mention Mitchell Robinson. You talked about Isaiah Hartenstein losing him. It was big. It was a big deal for me as well. What do you think about the state of the center rotation right now? Are you concerned? What's your biggest concern with the team right now?
I don't believe that Mitchell Robinson's going to make it through the season. And then who do we have? That's my concern. I don't think Sims is. And I was away for a few weeks. I don't know if there's been some other talks happening, but that concerns me. Him staying healthy.
Well, we talked about when we were recording this show, your previous life in the New York nightlife scene. Yeah. Did you see any Knicks out when they might not and they shouldn't have been out? Did you see any Knicks out? Any nightlife stories?
I've seen them. I've taken part in events with players from other teams from the Knicks. And there's definitely, if you live in New York, that's a threat. You got nightlife here, and these are young guys who want to be out, so... There's truth. These dudes are definitely partying in certain cities that affect the game the next day. There's just no getting around it.
Yeah.
So, I think we have a young... I think what I like about this team is these guys seem like... And Brunson's not a dude. They don't seem like the type of guys that are at the club till 4 a.m. So, they have bigger fish to fry. So.
Yeah. No, absolutely, man. What's been this journey here in starting and operating Burgerhead? What's been the journey like for you so far?
Yeah, it's been restaurant business, New York. Post-pandemic, it's a hard business, but we're really excited to be here. I partnered up with two childhood friends of mine to bring this to fruition. And, we believe that we have a unique burger concept for New York. Like I said, we do char-grilled burgers. It's nothing new. I almost would say it's the most classic type of American burger. And in a sea of smash burgers, we're trying to give something a little different. Our patty's more, it's a 4-ounce patty, you cook it on an open flame, comes on a sesame seed bun, comes with all the works, it's like your prototypical American style burger. And then, everything we do here, we try and do with love and with the best, freshest ingredients possible. And that's kind of our motto, and we're just hoping to slowly take over New York one neighborhood at a time.
Kind of feel like the qualities of being a Knicks fan is almost the same qualities you need to be in a business owner, right?
Of course, yeah. You gotta struggle, but there's a goal you're getting to, So you take good days, you take bad days, and you just keep working towards the goal. And so, like any business in New York, you work hard at it, and it's a competitive environment, and so you got to stand out and be the best. And, we hope to do that.
All right, so let's go rapid fire with some Knicks questions.
Oh, man. Okay.
Let's get into it. All right, favorite Knick of all time?
Ewing.
Patrick Ewing. Favorite Knick on the current...
I almost said Starks. I don't know why I said Ewing, but...
You see, Starks your guy or Ewing your guy? Ewing's my guy, but it changes all the
time. Yeah, I would say them interchangeably. That's just my memory.
Favorite Knick on this team?
Brunson.
Hated Knick rival of all time?
Pacers.
Player?
I'd say Reggie. Reggie Jordan, too. Yeah.
Reggie sucks, man.
I remember we once yelled at Jordan in Atlantis Casino. We were like, fuck you, Knicks.
Yeah. What, yeah. Did he even take his head up from the blackjack table? Yeah. He's like, I'm losing, whatever.
There's too much security. I think we got kicked out of the casino for that. But, yeah, man, as much as he's I think the best player the league has ever seen, he robbed us of many chances. Yeah. Yeah.
Favorite Knick moment of all time?
LJ's 4-point play against the Pacers and what was game 3 it was? Yeah. That was, I still remember that. So I remember I graduated high school not long after that. I remember my boy did the LJ on the stage and I just always remember that. And that was a great year.
We all have our hives, right? And being a member of a hive a lot of times is for a Knick player that really wasn't all that good, but you had a lot of high hopes for.
Nah, I mean, you thought, I guess for a minute, insanity, right? Okay. That he was going to do something and be like a long-term player to contribute to that team, but you know, we saw that kind of fizzled out. So I would say that,
Vegas has a Knick win total at around 52 games. Are you going over or under?
We're gonna do a little over. 53.
You going over?
Yeah.
You confident, man? You confident?
53, 54.
Okay.
I want to shoot for this, you know, I think this season's gonna be wild, man.
Yeah.
As long as we stay healthy, man, I think sky's the limit.
Final predictions, man. What do you see the Knicks finishing? So you said 53 games. Where do they finish in the playoffs?
Man, I hope we go all the way this year. I really think we're definitely making the Eastern Conference if everything stays healthy. So.
All right, my guy Will. Appreciate the hospitality, man. Burgerhead.
Love what you guys are doing. Excited for this season to watch you guys.
Any final thoughts for the Knicks fans out there?
Man, just we've been waiting a long time, so I think we're in the. We're in a good period right now. We got to enjoy it. We got to enjoy whatever's coming, so.
There we go, man. Appreciate it, bro.